ಅಂದೇ ವಾಂಚಿತ ಲಾಭಾಯ ಕರ್ಮ ಕಿಂ ತನ್ನ ಕಥ್ಯತೆ ಕಿಂ ದಂಪತಿ ಮಿತಿ ಬ್ರೂಯಾಂ ಉದಾಹೋ ದಂಪತಿ ಇತಿ. ವಿವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ ಇಂದ್ರ ಪ್ರಸ್ಥಾನಂ. ಸ ಕದಾಚಿತ್ ನಿರ್ಜಗಾಮ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲುಕ್ ಎಟ್ ದಿ ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಗ್ರಾಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ತಾರಾಪಥೇ ನಿರ್ಜಗಾಮ. ತಾರಾಪಥೇ ಇನ್ ದ ಪಾತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ನಕ್ಷತ್ರಸ್ ಹಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ನಿರ್ಜಗಾಮ. ಹಿ ಕೇಮ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಸಿಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಗೋ. ನೌ ವಿ ಸಾ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಡೈಲಿ ರೊಟೀನ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿ ಡಿಡ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ ಕದಾಚಿತ್ ಆಚಾರ ಇತಿ ಬೋಧಿತಃ ದರ್ಪಣ ಆಲೋಕ್ಯ ಕಾಮಧೇನು ಅಭ್ಯರ್ಚ್ಯ ಅಮರಧುನೀಂ ಆಸಾದ್ಯ. ಹಿ ವೆಂಟ್ ನಿಯರ್ ಗಂಗಾ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಹಿ ಡಿಡ್ ಶಿವಪೂಜಾ. ನೌ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನೆಸೆಸರಿ ಇನ್ ಅ ಪೂಜಾ? ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲುಕ್ ಎಟ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಪೂಜಾ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಧ್ಯಾನ, ಆಸನಂ, ಆವಾಹನಂ, ಆಸನಂ ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ, ಪಾದ್ಯಂ ಅರ್ಘ್ಯಂ ಆಚಮನೀಯಕಂ, ಮಧುಪರ್ಕ ಆಚಮನ ಸ್ನಾನ ವಸನ ಆಭರಣಾನಿ ಚ, ಸುಗಂಧಿ ಸುಮನೋ ಧೂಪ ದೀಪ ನೈವೇದ್ಯ ವಂದನಂ ಪ್ರಯೋಜಯೇತ್ ಅರ್ಚನಾಯಾಂ ಉಪಚಾರಾಂಸ್ತು ಷೋಡಶ. There are different types of upacharas. In the sense, there is a shodasha upachara, that is the ashtatrimshat upachara, shashti upachara, chatushashti upachara. In shaktam it is chatushashti, chatushashti upacharadhya, that is the prakriya for shaktam. So it differs based on each and every devata. Here Shiva being the ishta devata for Dikshitar, and he also talks, so he says Indra performs puja to Shivalinga. In the banks of Ganga, he makes lingam and he does the different shodashopachara for that Shiva. Okay, you understand? Just read one or two and then we will go one by one. Be easier.
ವಿವರ್ತಿತ ನಿಯಮಾಭಿಷೇಚನಃ ಸಿದ್ಧಚಾರಣ ಗಂಧರ್ವ ಸೇವಿತೆ ಸೈಕತೆ ತಸ್ಯಾಹ ದಹರಾಕಾಶ ಪರಿಪೂಜಿತ ದಿವ್ಯ ಲಿಂಗಾಕೃತಿಃ ಪ್ರತಿಷ್ಠಾಪ್ಯ ಚಿಂತಾಮಣಿ ಚಿಂತಾಮಣಿಮಯಂ ಕಿಮಪಿ ಪಾರಮೇಶ್ವರಂ ಲಿಂಗಂ.
ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ವಿತ್ ದಟ್ ನೌ. ನಿರ್ವರ್ತಿತ ನಿಯಮ ಅಭಿಷೇಚನಃ, ನಿರ್ವರ್ತಿತ ನಿಯಮ ಅಭಿಷೇಚನಃ, ಹಿ ಡಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ನಿಯಮ ಬೈ ರೂಲ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದಿ ಅಭಿಷೇಚನಂ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡನ್, ಹಿ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಅಭಿಷೇಕ ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಮ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಡಸ್ ಸ್ನಾನಂ. ಸ್ನಾನಂ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಈಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಫೈವ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಇಟ್. ಸ್ನಾನಂ ಸಂಕಲ್ಪ ಸೂಕ್ತ ಪಾಠನಂ ಮಾರ್ಜನಂ ಅಘಮರ್ಷಣಂ ದೇವತಾದಿ ತರ್ಪಣಂ ಚೈವ ಪಂಚಾಂಗಂ ಸ್ನಾನಂ ಉಚ್ಯತೆ. ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಫೈವ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಈವನ್ ಸ್ನಾನಂ, ವೇರ್ ಯು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಗಂಗೇ ಚ ಯಮುನೇ ಚೈವ ಯು ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ರಿವರ್ಸ್, ಯು ಪ್ರೇ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸಾನ್ನಿಧ್ಯಂ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಬಾತಿಂಗ್. ಈ ಡಸ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಆಲ್ ದಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಈ ಈಸ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಬಾತ್ ಇನ್ ಗಂಗಾ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ರೈಟ್? ವಿ ಸಾ ದಟ್, ರೈಟ್? ಭೂತಲ ಅಸಂಸ್ಪರ್ಶೆ ಅಪಿ ಭುವನ ಪಾವನೀಂ ಚರಣಾರವಿಂದ ಪರಮಪುರುಷ ಚರಣಾರವಿಂದ ಸ್ಪರ್ಶಾತ್. ಸೊ ನಿರ್ವರ್ತಿತ ನಿಯಮ ಅಭಿಷೇಕ, ಆಸ್ ಪರ್ ರೂಲ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ನಾನಂ. ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಸಿದ್ಧ ಚಾರಣ ಗಂಧರ್ವ ಸೇವಿತೆ ಸೈಕತೆ ತಸ್ಯಾಹ, ತಸ್ಯಾಹ ಗಂಗಾಯಾಹ ಸೈಕತೆ, ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಗಂಗಾ. The sands have been sevite, they sevita not necessarily worshipped, but they have constantly used that that shores of Ganga. That's what it means. Not sevanam is not only just praying. If you say aham kshiram seve, which means I take kshiram, I drink milk, that's what it means. So it depends on the context, you have to change the meaning of it. Here siddha charana gandharva sevite, in the sands of Ganga, which have been used by the siddhas, charana and gandharva, these are all different types of devas. What did he do? Daharakasha paripujita divyalinga akriti pratishthapya akriti chintamanimayam kimapi parameshwaram lingam pratishthapya. He thinks of the god first, right? That the god, the Shiva that he has been worshipping in his mind constantly, this Dharakasha is a very specific term where It means Brahmapure Daharam Pundarikam Veshma Daharo Asmin Antaha Akashaha. Daharam is a space that is supposed to be within the Hridayam. And in that Hridayam, there is an Akasha, which is called a Sukshma Akasha. And in that Akasha, Brahma Swarupam is supposed to exist. That is called Dharakasha. You think of the God being in there. You think of the Brahma Swarupam as present inside the Hridaya Guha, which is called the Dahara, which is in the form of a Padma, which is in the form of a lotus. And there is a small space there, and you think of the Atma Swarupam as being there. Now here, Indra has meditated upon Shiva inside that Dharakasha in the form of a Divya Linga. So, Dharakasha Paripujita, Divya Linga Akriti. So, he worships Shiva, who is in the divine form, present in his Dharakasha. Chintamani Mayam. Chintamani is one unique jewel. There are many different, ideas about the Chintamani. They say it is not a money that exists. It is just a very imaginary money. Or they say that it is a money which is, it is a ratnam which gives whatever you want. Chintamani, whatever you desire, it will give. Ambal's, this thing is supposed to be Chintamani, ratnamayam asanam, simhasanam. Chintamani is an imaginary thing where whatever you desire is supposed to be given by that, if you have that jewel. So Chintamani Mayam Parameshwaram Lingam. In fact, in the Vyakhyanam he says, Chintamanau Shivam Dhyatva Sarvan Kama Namapnuyat is a Shastra line. If you meditate upon Shiva using that Chintamani Ratnam, then you get all your desires fulfilled. So, Kimapi Parameshwaram Lingam. Kimapi. Kimapi ityukte anirvachaniyam. Wherever you find that, you just put it as anirvachaniyam. You cannot explain the beauty of that lingam that is there in front of you. Right? Tadrisha lingam pratishthapya. Now you have asanam here. Right? Avahanam and asanam. Right? Avahanam is whatever is there in his mind, you bring forth and get the presence of the God there. Shiva. Then you have asanam. Asanam is pratishtha. You give him a space to stay, which is the Ganga Tire. Next, anusandhaya tatra.
Anusandhaya tatra naka likhita sharat chandra chandrika sara sundaram bhagavantam madanantakam.
One by one we'll do, because each one is a part of the Shodashopachara. That's how he has brought it. So the first one you had dhyana, avahanam and asanam. Next you have the dhyanam. Dhyanam is you meditate upon the Lord, right? So tatra ityukte linge, tadrisha divya linge, nakha vilikita sharachandra chandrika. Now, first he said kimapi, where it was anirvachaniyam. There is no, you cannot describe the beauty of it. Now he gives a form to it. He gives, attaches some gunas to it. You have something called nirvikalpakam and then savikalpakam. In the dhyanam, there are two parts. One is you meditate upon something which is like Jyoti Swarupam, where there are no guna, no kriya, nothing. Then you come to the savikalpakam. Savikalpakam is what Chandra Chuda. The first thing that is attractive about Shiva is that Chandran that he has in his mind. Actually, there is this, I'm reminded of that shloka in Bhartrihari's Vairagya Shatakam, where he says, you know, I don't have any difference between Vishnu or Shiva. No problem. Because Vishnu, as far as Shiva goes, Maheshwareva Jagatam Adhishware. He is the Ishwara, or he is the controller of the entire world. He's fine. Maheshwareva Jagatam Adhishware Janardaneva Jagat Antaratmani. Narayana is supposed to be the Antaratma for the entire world. Na Vastu Bheda Pratipattirastime. I don't have any difference as far as the two of them. Tathapi Bhakti. My personal bhakti is towards Shiva, but when he describes Shiva, he says, Tathapi Bhakti Tarunendu Shekhare. Taruna Indu Shekhare, the one who has that in the Yalan Chandrana, the Chandra that he has in his The Chandra has such an important, it's an important feature, right? Immediately attracts you. So here, that's why he says, Nakha Vilikita Sharat Chandra Chandrika Sara Sundara. The beauty of Chandrika that comes from the Sharat Chandra, which he has drawn with his Nakha. And you don't need any big thing to, you know, Chandra, he doesn't have to keep on external objects there. If you look at how, you know, many people, when they do Chandana Abhishekam, they put Chandana on the Lord, and then with their nails, they will just curve the eyes and all. It'll just be one swipe, beautiful swipe that they do. That is how you have to imagine the way Indra has done that. Nakha Vilikita Sharat Chandra Chandrika Asara Sundaram. He just writes that, draws that Chandra, and then the Chandrika, the moonlight comes, and the Lord is so beautiful because of that. Tadrisham Bhagavantam Madanantakam. One who destroyed Manmatha. Madanantakam Bhagavantam Anusandhaya. Anusandhaya meaning dhyana. He thinks of the Lord in that tatra anusandhaya. He does dhyanam of that Lord in that lingam.
Abhishichya divyapaga salilaihi.
Abhishichya divyapaga. Divyapaga is Ganga. Ganga salilaihi abhishichya abhishekam kritva. That is snanam.
Anulipya rohini ramana hari harina madana madapankanushangina harichandanena.
So harichandanena anulipya. Next is anulepanam or chandanam. He has skipped a few here. We will just take it as he has done it. So when you say divyapaga salilehi abhishichya, we can take that as indicating both padyam, argyam, achamaniikam, all of that included there. Okay, because he doesn't do that separately. Next he moves on to chandanam. Chandanam is Rohini Ramana. Rohini is a nakshatra. So Rohini is Ramana, Nayaka is Chandra. Chandre yaha mrigaha vartate saha harinaha. So that mriga madapanka, you know, there is this musk that comes from the musk deer. So for that deer, he mentions that it is the mriga that is there in Chandra. So Chandre yaha harinaha tadrisha harinasya madapanka. Madapankena anushangina. Anushangina, it is mixed with. So Harichandana, the Rakta Chandanam, is mixed with the musk or the perfume. So this is also the Sugandhi, Gandham, Anulepanam, all of these also you do in the Shodashopachara, right? So Harichandanena Anulipya, he anoints the Shiva with this Chandana.
Samabhyatya Ganga Gangeya Vikacha Gangeya Pankajaihi.
So Gangeya Pankajaihi Samabhyarchya. Gangeya has two meanings. One is Gangayaha or Gangayam Utpannani or Gangayam Utpannani is Gangeyam. The other meaning is Swarna. So there are two meanings here, because the Akasha Ganga has golden lotuses. That's what they say. Suvarna Pankajani Vidyante. So Gangeya Vikacha. Gangayam Utpannani Tatha Vikachani Cha Vikasitani. So the flowers, the lotuses, Ganga's lotuses, golden lotuses that were bloomed. He took those lotuses and did Archana. Samabhyarchya. Next.
Aradhya. Surabhi Drita Dhara Dharanu Bandhina Divya Dhupena Nisarga Chalita Rashmi Mala Kalapena Ratna Deepena Cha.
Here next is Dhupa Deepa Naivedyam. These are the next three, right? So Gandha Dhupa Deepa Naivedyam. Now Dhupam, what does he do? Divya Dhupena, with the very divine Dhupam, he Aradhya, he does Aradhana. That Dhupam is mixed, Anubandhina. It is mixed with the Dhara, that is a droplets of Surabhi Grita, very fragrant ghee. It is a neidipam, the dhupam neyyavittu, that is this, it is not the powder dhupa that you just throw, like that samrani which you throw and it just gives us fragrance. That's not what it is. So the powder is mixed with the fragrant ghee and oil and then made into one, like that dashanga. That is the dhupa that he uses to show for the Lord. Next is nisarga dhipam. Wow, how is this dhipam? This is not something which you just light and then switch off at the end of the day. You just, you know, close the deepam and then close the doors. That's not how it is. He takes the Ratna deepam, which is always shining. Nisarga chalita. Nisarga always chalita. It is shining. Rashmi mala kalapena. It has a rays, Rashmi mala kalapak samoham. Rashmi nam samoha yatra vidyate. Tadrisha Ratna deepam. So Ratna Deepena, what does she do? Nivedya. Ratna Deepena Aradhya. So until that you have to put a comma. So Surabhi Grita Dara Anubandina Divyadupena Tatha Nisarga Chalita Rashmimala Kalapena Ratna Deepena Cha Aradhya. Aradhanam Kritva. What does he do? Nivedya.
Next. Samgaya Sayudhaya Savarnaya Sabharnaya Cha Nivedya Sadhya Samahrita Nishpiditendu Mandala Nishyandamana Paryu
Aparyushita
Aparyushitanya Amrita Aparyushitanya Amritani
Aparyushitani Amritani. Okay. Amritani Nivedya. Next, for Naivedyam, we usually make so many dishes. The greatest that you can get, which is the Amritam. Right? So he gives that Amritam as Naivedya. So Amritani Nivedya. Now, how are these Amritam? Aparyushitani. It has not been eaten before or it has not been drunk before. Fresh Amrita. Where do you get this fresh Amrita? Amritam is supposed to be there in Indu Kirana. So he takes the Indu Kirana and then he just crushes them fresh and then he gives it to Shiva for Naivedya. Sadhya Samahrita, freshly it has been collected, Samahrita. Nishpidita, he crushes it. The water, what does he crush? Indu Mandala. And from that Indu Mandalam, the Nishyanda, though that which drops from the Indu Mandala, that has not been eaten before, Aparyushitam. Paryushitam means that which is you have eaten and then you have kept reserved some for the next day, right? Or for the next time. That's not what it is. So Aparyushitam means it is never untouched before. That sort of an Amritani Nivedya. For whom does he do this? He does it for, he gives four adjectives for, you know, Shiva, where he says Sangaya Sayudhaya Savaranaya Sabharanaya. Abharanam is one thing, then Vastram, you have to give all these things and then you have to do Naivedya, right? So before doing Naivedya, Dhupa Deepa, actually before doing Dhupa Deepam, you have to do this. Dhupa Deepa is immediately after the Chandana Anulepanam and then Dhupa Deepam, then you do Anga Puja, which is Sangaya. There are two things about it. Anga means, one is, there is Anga Devata, which is Durga, Ganapati, Kartikeya, Rudra, Brahma. All of these are called Anga Devatas or Parivara Devata. This is Anga Devata is different from the Parivara Devata. Correct. Anga Devata is, for every puja, you have different Anga Devatas and you have to perform pujas for each and every Anga Devata also. All of these are available in agamas and each agama differs on who are the Anga Devatas for which Devata. So if the Pradhana Devata is Satyanarayana, then you have different Anga Devatas. If the Pradhana Devata is Devi, then according to the Navavarana Puja, then you have different Anga Devatas, different Avarana Devatas and everything. Right? So it differs based on, even for Shiva, it depends on which agama you follow. We can't define and give that because it is a paddhati that each one follows. Then ayudham. Sayudhaya, you give ayudham to the Lord also. Everything, right? You have all these small, small things that you have made with the gold or whatever, chamaram, chatram, everything he gives. So sayudha is ayudham, or you have his pinaka, trishula, and different types of ayudham you are giving him, and then he is performing the puja. Next is avarana. This avarana is a very technical term as far as Shaiva goes. Avarana devatas are, avaranam is actually vastram. That is one meaning. So you can say sa vastraya, sa abharanaya. Both of these are, you are giving vastram samarpayami and avaranam samarpayami. That is one part. But this avarana also has another meaning. There are something called avarana devatas. If you go to a temple, you will find many, the pradhana devata might be Shiva, but there are other devatas who are in each and every directions. There are many avarana devatas like Brahma, Dikpalaka, even Shiva is one of the devata, not Sadashiva, but Rudra, Bhairava, and all of these are all called avarana devatas or parivara devata. Along with them, which means his puja must be so elaborate, no? That he did Indra. So savaranaya, sabharanaya, devaya, shivaya, amritani nivedya. After giving naivedyam, you have vandanam. Vandanam can be of different types. It is pradakshinam, namaskara, stotra, many types can be there. He does all of those.
Pradakshani, pranipatya, prasadya, panchabhi, prasunanjalibihi.
Prasunanjalibihi, stutva, continue until then.
Stutva, shrutishirobhi, kritva, visarjani, atha, mritva, chirantana matmani.
Matmani, let it be till that. So with that, the puja is done. So pradakshini kritya, then he does the pradakshina, he goes around the lingam. Pranipatya is of two types. One is ashtanga sashtangam namaskaram or panchangam namaskaram. For men, it is sashtanga, where 8 parts of the body touch the ground. Panchanga, where 5 parts of the body touch the ground. That is for women. So pranipatya namaskaram kritva. Then panchabihi prasunanjalibihi prasadya. Prasadya, with 5 different types of flowers, prasuna, flowers, anjali bihi, pushpanjali. With 5 types of pushpanjali, he asks for prasadya, in the sense he makes him happy. He makes Shiva happy with 5 types of flowers. There are 2 things again here. One is Shiva loves flowers. Any flower you can take and put for Shiva. There is no condition there. In fact, he likes something called Tumbapu, where in India, in South, we have a small white color flower, which just grows on the road, but that is supposed to be what Shiva likes a lot. Something which you won't even think of plucking and putting it for the Lord, such a small, tiny white flower. It's called Tumbapu. That you will put for Shiva. Shiva is very happy with any flower you give him. That's why he is called Ashu Toshaha. Ashu Tushyati. He quickly becomes very happy about it. So if you give him such an elaborate puja, then that's it. That's why he gives so much of varan, you know, boons to all these rakshasas, because they know how to please Shiva. Panchabihi prasuna anjali bihi, 5 different types of prasuna anjali, pushpanjali bihi, prasadya. Prasadya ityukte kshamapanam kritva. Kshamapayitva, in the sense, avahanam na janami visarjanam, puja vidhim na janami, kshamasva parameshwara. That is the shloka that you say when you ask for kshamapanam. End of it, you say, there may have been so many lapses in whatever I have done. Na kayena vacha manasendriyairva buddhyatmanava prakrite swabhava karomi yadyat sakalam parasme ta narayanayeti samarpayami. That one is also where you say, whatever mistakes I have done, it is all I give it to you, right? Samarpanam. That kshamapanam is also puja vidhim na janami. I don't know any of these niyama. So you have to forgive any lapses in the process that I have done. That is also called prasadam, prasadanam. So prasadya ಕ್ಷಮಾಪಣಂ ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥಯಿತ್ವ ಸ್ತುತ್ವ ಶ್ರುತಿ ಶಿರೋಭಿ. ಶ್ರುತಿ ಶಿರಃ ಇಸ್ ಉಪನಿಷತ್, ಉಪನಿಷತ್ ಬಿಹಿ ಸ್ತುತ್ವ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಮಂತ್ರ ಪುಷ್ಪಂ. ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಕೃತ್ವ ವಿಸರ್ಜನ, ವಿಸರ್ಜನ ಇತ್ಯುಕ್ತೆ ಪುನರಾಗಮನ, ಯಚ ಯು ಲೆಟ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಗೋ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಕಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ದೇರ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿಸರ್ಜನ. ಯು ಯು ಡೂ ಆವಾಹನ ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ ವಿಸರ್ಜನ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯು ಕಾಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ದೇರ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ಈಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಎನಫ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಹಿ ಸಿಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಸ್ ಧ್ಯಾನ. ಅಥ ಸ್ಮೃತ್ವ ಚಿರಂತನಂ ಆತ್ಮನಿ. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ವಿಸರ್ಜನ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಲಿಂಗಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಾನ್, ಬಟ್ ದೆನ್ ಹೀ ಥಿಂಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಚಿರಂತನಂ ಶಿವಂ ಪರಮೇಶ್ವರಂ ಆತ್ಮನಿ ಸ್ಮೃತ್ವ. ಇನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಓನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಹೀ ದೆನ್ ಸಿಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್. ದಿಸ್ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಪೂಜಾ ವಿಧಿ ಇಸ್ ಡನ್, ಬಟ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಟ್, ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಕಾಯಿಕಂ, ಹೀ ಗೋಸ್ ಟು ಮಾನಸಿಕ. ಮಾನಸಿಕ ಪೂಜಾ ಇಸ್ ಮಚ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ದೆನ್ ದ ಕಾಯಿಕ ಪೂಜಾ. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಹೀ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಔಟ್. ಹೀ ವಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಔಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸಿಟಿ, ರೈಟ್?
ವಿಲಾಸ ವೀಥಿ ವಿಹಾರ ಕೌತೂಹಲೇನ ನಿಗತ್ಯ ಬಹಿಃ ನಿರ್ಗತ್ಯ ಬಹಿಃ.
ನಿರ್ಗತ್ಯ ಬಹಿಃ ನಿರ್ಗತ್ಯ, ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಶೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗಂಗಾ. ಹಿ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಔಟ್. ವೈ, ವೇರ್ ಡಸ್ ಹಿ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಗೋ ನೌ? ವಿಲಾಸ, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫನ್, ವೀಥಿ ವಿಹಾರ ಕೌತೂಹಲೇನ. ವೀಥಿ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಮರಾವತಿ. ಈ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ವಿಹಾರ ಸಂಚಾರ. ವೀಥಿಷು ಸಂಚಾರಸ್ಯ ಕೌತೂಹಲಂ ತಸ್ಯ ವರ್ತತೆ. ಸೊ ಕೌತೂಹಲಂ ಇತ್ಯುಕ್ತೆ ಈಗರ್ನೆಸ್. He wants to just roam around the place just for fun and see. So he gets out there. The moment he gets out, he's a king. Remember that. Now, people are just waiting to entertain him. The moment they see his face, they will immediately start making a noise. Now, when a celebrity shows his face, or when a great personality comes out and shows his face, immediately there is one ghosham, right? Jaya ghosham. That the army that does the jaya ghosham in front of the, and which goes in front of the nayaka, is called sena mukham or nasira. It's another word for sena mukham, agrasena. That is he starts the description of that sena from this part. So all of this, it's not complete. So everything you'll have to go and look at a couple of pages later where it says Sena Mukham Alokya. Until that, this is going to connect there. Okay. Itastuta.
Itastuta. Nirantara. 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 Lamila.
Milat.
Nirantara. Nirantara. Milat. Ashovar. ಆಶೀರ್ವಚೋ ಮುಖರ ಗೀರ್ವಾಣ ಮುನಿ ಸಂಘ ಸಂಕುಲಂ.
ಸಂಕುಲಂ, ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ವಿತ್ ದಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್. ಸಿ, ವೆನ್ ಹಿ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸೇನಾ, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆನಿ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ದ ಸೀನ್, ಇಂದ್ರ ಇಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಮೋಮೆಂಟ್ ಹಿ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಔಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಹ್ಯೂಜ್ ಗ್ಯಾದರಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ದೇರ್. There are four parts. One is, there is a set of Muni group who are giving him Ashirvada Vachanam. That is one set. The next set are the Apsarastris. Inside that Apsarastris, you have different groups where one is playing Mridanga, one is playing Venu, the other is Veena, the other is starting to sing, and the other set is starting to dance. That is one group. The next group is the set of people who have the authority, and with a bamboo staff, they keep hitting the ground and saying, apasara, apasara, they move around, move so that the king can come. So when the king has to come, people have to move about and stand in line. So there are these bamboo staff people, our officers who are standing there and hitting the ground and saying, move. And the the devas are all falling in line. Then the fourth set of people are the actual Sena. Now, this entire group, Agrasena, has four parts, where the first is Munikula, Apsarakula, then Vetra Lata Dhari, and then the Sena, Kari, where you have the Gaja, Turaga, etc. Vahanas. So the first one is Itastataha, here and there, Nirantarala, without any gap, that sena sound is being milat, it is mixed with the ashirvacho mukhara, ashirvacha ashirvada vachanam kesham girvana muni sangha sankulasya. So girvana is a very nice word. I just realized the meaning of it. Gihi vak, gihi is vak, that gira, we have found that right, ma bhaishihi iti gira avirasa, that gihi is the banam or astram for those people, muni. They can destroy a person's life with just their words. That is what girvana means. I thought girvana till now was just the devas. Girvana is more the naradadi muni munayaha. Muni sangha sankulam, girvana muni sangha sankulam. So the powerful muni are all mukhara. They are very noisy with their ashirvachaha, ashirvada vakyam, which is milat, which is mixing with the sena noise. And that is nirantarala, without any space. Antaralam is space, nirantarala is without any obstruction. It is continuously, this ashirvada vachanam is coming from them on one side. Next.
ಲಾಘಾತ ಶೋಧಿತ ಮೃದಂಗ ನಾದ ಭಂಗಿಗಭಿಹಿ
ಭಂಗಿಭಿಹಿ
ಭಂಗಿಭಿಹಿ ಅಧರ ನಿವೇಶಿತ ನಿವೇಶಿತ ಆಪೀನ ಅಪನೀತ ವೇಣುಭಿಹಿ ಅಸಕೃದ್ ಅಸಕೃದಾಸ್ ಫಲಿತ ಅಕೃಷ್ಟ ವೀನಾ ಗುಣಾಭಿಹಿ.
We'll stop with that. So where it goes is, three lines later if you find, it'll say apsarobihi arapsyamana tauryatrikam. That is where it is going and getting connected. So apsarobihi, apsarastribihi, arapsyamana, tauryatrikam. Tauryatrikam are nritya, gita and vadya form a set of three, which is called tauryatrikam, trayaha amshaha, nrityam, geetam and vadyam. All of these three are being mentioned in this entire section, starting from atikomala to arapsyamana tauryatrikam. What are the three parts? He first starts with vadyam. And then he goes to Geeta, and then last he looks at the Nrityam. Now, Vadyam, there are three Vadyams that are mentioned here. One is Mridanga, next is Venu, next is Veena. What do they do? This is Arapsyamana. Remember that in your mind. They have not started. They are going to start. It is in future tense. Okay. They are going to start, but before they start, if you have gone to a concert, you will know. When a Carnatic concert or something is starting, or a dance concert is starting, if you see the mridangam, they will first try to see how it is. They will check the shruti, right? Shodhita mridanganada bhangi bihi. Even that testing for the shruti will be very beautiful to hear. They have a rhythm to do it, right? They don't do randomly. They just don't hit the instrument like that. But here, ati komala, very soft anguli dala, the front portion of the fingers. They don't do the chapu. They just do only the front portion of their fingers to listen to the shruti and check the shruti of it. So ati komala anguli dala aghata, by just the anguli agrehi aghata taadita mridanganada. Shodhita mridanganada. Shodhita is analyzing the sound of the mridangam, which is very beautiful. Bhangi bihi. This is all going to our apsarobihi. So some of the apsaras start the mridanga sound by playing it with the front portions of their fingers, which are very soft. Ati komala. They don't do harsh hitting. So ati komala angulidala aghata shodhita mridanganada bhangibihi. They have still not started playing. They are going to play. So this is a precursor. Next, what do the venu, the apsaras threes who have the venu, that is a flute in their hands, they adhara niveshita apanita. They keep it in their mouth to check the shruti and then take it out. Adhara niveshita apanita venubihi. The flutes come to near their lips, adhara lips. Adhara niveshita, they keep it near their lips, blow, test it, and then apanita, remove it. Next, asakrita, again and again, aspalita, the veena. Veena gunabihi, guna is tantri. The strings of the veena are being aspalita, hit, tadita, and akrishta, they are being pulled. So they pull, you know, and testing the strings of they will pull it so that the shruti is proper or not. So they try to strum it and see whether it is fine. Asakrit, sakrit means just once, asakrit means many times. You can't just do it once and say, okay, done. Nobody is such a great expert with, even for Apsaras 3, you have to test it a couple of times to see if it is fine. And there are, that is Aspalita, Akrishta, Asakrita, Aspalita, Akrishta, Veena, Gunabhi. The Veena, Gunaha, the strings of the Veena are being strummed once or twice. Okay. Next, Akunchita.
Akunchita, Rujukrita, Grulata. Bhulatam avishkrita lupta sira bandhaka bandha tandharam antareva kala madhuram arabdha geeti bihi
kala madhuram is beautiful. Kala is sweet sounding. So kala madhuram arabdha geeti bihi, very sweetly, all of these three, if you find, akunchita raju krita brulatam arabdha geeti bihi, all of these three go to arabdha, which is, so it is a kriya visheshanam for arabdham. So akunchita raju krita brulatam, how do they start singing? So before you start singing, you will test, right? You will hum, and then you while humming, as you listen, you will scrunch your eyebrows a little bit and then straighten it. Okay, that is fine. And then you will try to extend your throat and see. So as you sing, as you hum, sometimes all the veins can show or they will go back. He describes it so beautifully in the sense, his observation power is so high. So akunchita rujukrita. Akunchita, you scrunch your eyebrows. And then rujukrita, ruju is straight. And then straightening of brulata, the eyebrows. Along with this, they started their geetam. So when they are singing, they will be probably in that mode. But before they start, when they are testing, they will see if it is correct or not. Right? And then, okay, it is correct. They will test it by, you can see the facial expressions that are there. This is more like a Drishyakavyam here. Avishkrita, Lupta, Sirabandha, Kandharam. Kandharam is both the shoulder and it is also the neck, the neck portion. So when they are trying to sing or before starting, they're testing the voice. What do they do? Avishkrita, the Sirabandha is the bundle of veins that are there in the near the throat. So Sirabandha, Bandhaha, Avishkritaha. It means they're showing their veins or lupta or it is disappearing. Okay, so either by showing their veins or by then they make the veins disappear. Tadrisham kalamadhuram arabdha geetibihi. Thus they start singing, they try to sing kalamadhuram. Antareva, oh that is very important, that antareva is what? Antaha eva, inside itself means they are humming. They have not opened their mouth and started singing. Even just by humming, it was so beautiful. Go to a great artist and all, you will know. Before they start, they will first hum the first phrase of the ragam. They won't open their mouth and sing with full throat voice. Even that will be very beautiful when they just do that humming and test their voices. That's what it is saying. So what to say of Apsaras 3, right? Even with normal people we see here, it is so beautiful. So akunchita rujukrita brulatam avishkrita lupta sirabandha kandharam kalamadhuram arabdha geetibihi.
Manjira Manjulabhi मञ्जुलाभिर् अप्सरोभिर् अप्सरोभिः आरप्स्यमान तौर्यत्रिक्रम्
त्रिकम् सो इन् द त्रौर्यत्रिकम् वि सा द वाद्यं गीतं नौ वि हव् टु कम् टु नृत्यम् देर् इस् अनदर् सेट् आफ् अप्सरस् त्री हू आर् स्टाण्डिङ्ग् देर् अण्ड् दे वाण्ट् टु स्टार्ट् डान्सिङ्ग् नौ आल् आफ् दिस् विल् हेपन् ओन्लि इफ् इन्द्रा गिव्स् द सिग्नल् यु हाव् टु रिमेम्बर् देट् okay ashirvada vachanam will automatically happen but if he is in the mood of listening to this or if he is in the mood of seeing the dance then they will start dancing but they are ready ever ready to do it whenever indra shows the action right so what are the dancers doing dvihi trihi dvistrihi ityukte dvivaram trivaram va aspalita savyacharana mridu ranita manjira manjulabhihi apsarobhihi the other group of dancers they have manjira manjula the very beautiful anklets in their legs which is mridu ranitam are softly making a sound but where is that sound coming from it is coming from only the left leg savya charana aspalita because they are beating their stepping their left foot twice or thrice there is a soft sound that is coming out of the anklets such apsarobhihi tadrisha apsarobhihi arapsyamana tauryatrikam so the mridangam they are slowly tapping and checking out venu they keep to their mouth and then take it out and rest it and then veena they are strumming the strings constantly the singing people are also humming and trying to find out whether it is okay or not then the dancers they are testing again they are also you know showing their impatience or they are saying they are ready it's a sign of showing that you are ready they don't do it with force if it is with force then the manjira shabdam will be kalakala dhvani it will be very noisy whereas here mridu ranitam it's very soft and beautiful sound that comes out of the ankles tadrishaptaru apsarobhihi arapsyamana tauryatrikam that is important they are going to start ആരംഭം കരിഷ്യമാണ് തൗര്യത്രികം നൗ ദ തേർഡ് സെറ്റ് ഓഫ് പീപ്പിൾ വി സോ ദ മുനി ആൻഡ് ദെൻ ദി അപ്സര സ്ത്രീ നൗ വി കം ടു ദ വേത്രലതാ ധാരി അതി ഉദ്ഭട സോ അത്യുദ്ഭട
ക്ഷമിതം അത്യുദ്ഭട വേത്രി വേത്രലതാ ഘാത വിദ്രാവിത ഘാത വിദ്രാവിത വീതി ഭവ ഭവദ
ഭവത് അമര
ഭവത് അമരമണ്ഡലം
ദിസ് ഈസ് വൺ നൗ വേത്രി വേത്രി ആർ പീപ്പിൾ ഹു ആർ കാരിയിങ് എ വേത്ര വേത്ര ഈസ് ആക്ച്വലി എ കേൻ ഓർ എ ബാംബൂ സ്റ്റാഫ് so there are of people who are guards who will carry vetralata this entire set if you look at it this is what he must have found in Tirumala Nayaka's court these people would have been waiting there for him for to show him dance and there will be people who are standing there in front of the you know guard doorkeepers with bamboo staffs or cane staffs that is called vetri a person who is carrying that bamboo staff or a doorkeeper he is vetralata vetralata is the staff that he has in his hand so with the staff vetralata what do they do aghata they keep hitting on the ground when they hit on the ground vidravita what is the reaction for that vidravita is dravati is running or dhavati vidravita is to making them causing them to run or causing them to move whom the amara mandala all of this remember it is going it is an adjective to sena mukham okay so the other set of people who are there in that sena in the agre sarika sena that is amara mandalam there are groups of devas who are standing there what do they do vithi bhavat what is a vithi is a margam it also means pankti varsha adhaadu or line they all start standing in lines so the moment you hear something you know it's like the claps that the teacher gives or the bell that she rings the moment you ring the bell everybody comes and stands in line right or when the PT master blows a whistle they come and stand in line that is how they are behaving all conditioning so adi udbhata vetri vetralata aghata that adi udbhata means very fearsome or utkrishtam proud sound it can either go to adi udbhata vetri or adi udbhata aghata you can do put it as an adjective for both. Okay, so very fearsome or something we cannot be tolerated, intolerable people, because the moment you look at them, they command respect, right? So ati udbhata vetri or ati udbhataha vetri vetralata aghataha, very fearsome sound or very loud sound that comes by the hitting of that vetralata. Because of that sound, the Amara Mandalam Vidravita, they move and they form a line. Viti Bhavati. Okay, next.
Abhito Drishti Gurujara Sannidhapita Kari Turaga Paryankikari Nana Vidha Vahana Grama Malokya.
Now this is where he stops. So senamukham alokya. Etadrisha senamukham alokya. Senamukham is the nayakasya agre jaya ghoshena saha ya sena sarati. Tadrisha sena. Abhitaha abhi. The fourth set of things is the vahana. What are all the vahanas that are present there? Abhitaha api, sarvataha api, drishti gochara sandhapita. They would have probably been somewhere else, right? All these vahanas, they would not be present there always. But the moment they knew that Indra is woken up and he has gone to the shores of Ganga to perform the puja, everything else has been brought near. So sannidhapita, sannidhane prapitam, iti sannidhapita. They have been brought within the range of his sight. Drishti gochara sannidhane samipe prapitaha. What are those? Kari turagadi vahanani. So kari gaja, turaga ashwa horse, paryankika is the palanquin, that is palki. You know, the pallak that we have, that is called paryankika. These are the different types of, etc. Means you can't even imagine what types of vahanas can there be. Right? So, tatha nanavida vahana gramam. Gramam ityukte samuha. Vahana samuham. Vahana samuhena vartamanam senamukham alokya. So, he looked at it. Now, what was the effect of the way he looked at it? So there should be an effect of it, right? So the people who are surrounding him immediately understand what he wants. Huh? So he looks at the Sena and he looks at the old Mahots also who are there. Very beautifully the next line he says. So this is, he describes the elephant. Now next he climbs on an elephant. Now that elephant has been brought by the Mahots, and then in front of him Menaka is there, and behind him Brahma is also there. So there are many people who immediately come and stand with him. Read that.
Aloka matra
viditongitaihi.
Aloka matra viditongitaihi.
Adhorana vriddhaihi.
Oh, adhorana vriddhaihi, va?
Yes.
I don't have to. Oh. Adhorunaihi upasthapitam arnava nimagna nainaka paksha rakshanabhyartha nayagatam. Rakshanabhyartana mayagatam. Himavanta mivonnata
avadatam.
Kanchidarusya matangajam.
Matangajam kanchit aruhya. Matangajaha is very good elephant. Uttamagaja. Matangajaha, matangajaha, uttamagajaha. So uttamagajam ekam kanchit aruhya. He climbs onto an elephant. Now this elephant has been brought by alokamatra vidita ingitaihi. The moment Indra saw senamukham alokya, the moment he saw adhorana vriddhaihi, adhorana are mahot, hastipakaha. only the old people who are there, who are taking care of the elephants, they immediately understand the ingitam. Ingitam is abhipraya vishesha. What you cannot say with your mouth, what you don't say with your mouth, the abhipraya, it is something that is abhipraya anurupa cheshta. Abhipraya anurupa cheshta. That is called ingitam. Whatever you are thinking, you want to convey it, but you just say like this, no? Some gestures that show your intention. That only those mahot, that old mahots can understand. So, aloka matra vidita ingitaihi adhorana vrittaihi. There is an adjective for that. Visheshna. Vrittaihi upastapitam. Samipe anitam matangajam. How is that matangaja, that gaja, that elephant is unnatam avadatam cha. It is very tall and avadatam. Avadatam has two meanings. One is white and one is gold. Contextually, you have to take it. Here, if you look at it, it is actually white. Avadata means white because he compares it to himavantam eva, just like Himalayas, himavan. Himavantam eva unnatam avadatam matangajam aruhya. Why does he compare? How has he compared it here? Arnava nimagna mainaka paksha rakshana abhyartanaya. Himavan's son is Mainaka. Mainaka is the only one who retained his paksha, his wings. And he went into the sagara. Right? He was the one who rose and gave rest for Hanuman when he traveled to Lanka. So Arnava nimagna, the Mainaka Parvata, who was submerged in the ocean, in order to protect his wings, Himavan came directly to ask Indra, it seems. It was like that. The elephant is so white and tall that it looked like as if Himavan came directly there to ask for Mainaka, to ask for the protection of Mainaka. Okay, so Arnave Nimagnam Mainakam Tasya Pakshasya Rakshanartham Rakshanasya Prarthanaya Abhyartanaya Agatam Himavantam Iva Unnatam Avadatam Cha Matangajam. Now, I think it is both Utpreksha and Upama Alankara. It is not only Upama Alankara. So, Abhyartanaya is actually Hetu Utpreksha, right? 1 minute, let me just check that. Yeah. So, both Upama and it is Hetu Utpreksha also. Okay. Because he is fancying the cause for why Himavan has come. That is also there. And he compares the elephant with the Himavan also. Next.
Angaja Rabhya Devata Devata Eva Sharirinya Tambula Karanda Varinya Menakaya.
We'll stop with that. So, Menakaya, it goes to the next one also. Adhyasita Charama Bhagaha. Oh, read the next one also. Better.
Madana Madaka
Kadushna. We saw this word again in the Ganga description. Kadushna.
Madana Mada Kadushna Sauvarga Kamani Kataksha Santarga Nivarana Eva Manichamaroka Bijana Kushalara
Kushalarambhaya
Kushalarambhaya Rambhaya Savilasa Madhyasita Charama Bhaga.
We'll stop with that. So Angaja Rajya Saubhagya Devataya Sharirinya Eva Tambula Karanda Dharinya Menakaya. Menaka is holding his betel nuts. It's called Vetalapoti. In Tamil we call it Vetala. The Tambulam, you put it in one potti, in one box, and there is a carrier for that. There is always one side person who will carry that for you. For Indra, it is Menaka who is carrying the betel nut box. So Tambula Karanda Petika Dharini Menaka. Now, menakaya adhyasita charamabhagaha. Charamabhaga ityukte prishtabhagaha. So, Indra goes in front with the on the elephant, and then Menaka follows him. Okay? Menaka and Ramba, both of them follow. So, what is the description for Menaka? Menaka looks like as if it is the Manmatha's beauty has taken a form and come here. Now, Rajya Lakshmi, in the same way, here he says Angaja. Angaja ityukte Angate Jayate Manmatha. So Manmatha, the moment you look at somebody's form, you fall in love with them. And that is why Manmatha is Angate Jayate. Angaihi Jayate. So Angajaha or Anangaha, there is another word for him. He does not possess any form or any parts, but he is born out of the people's parts because you get attracted by seeing the form. So Angajaha Manmathaha Tasya Rajya Lakshmi Rajya Saubhagya Devata. Chulu commentary.
Sorry, Angaja ke enna sonnen first na.
Angaihi Jayate. So the first impression always comes, or Manmatha's effect is only because of the Anga, right?
Oh, okay.
Adhanala Angajaha na unukku.
Not Vandu Vishnu, Vishnu Odeya.
That is another one. Vishnu Odeya Sharirama Irindadina Kuda Adu Vandu Avatarama Dhani Eduttu Ponuma. Angajaha will not be directly applicable there. Angate Sambhavati Ingra Madri Eduttukalam.
So, idhudhaan
that's what I feel. That is what Shabdakalpatruma also has.
Sari, sari.
Angaihi Jayate Indra Potrukku. அதுல இல்ல யா சோ ஆமா அங்கஜ மன்மதஸ்ய ராஜ்ய சௌபாகிய தேவதையா ஷரீரிண்யா இவ ஆஸ் இஃப் த ராஜ்யலக்ஷ்மி பியூட்டி ஆஃப் தட் ராஜ்யம் ஆஃப் மன்மதா ஹேஸ் டேக்கன் அ ஃபார்ம் அண்ட் கம் ஹியர் இட் இஸ் லைக் த பர்சானிபிகேஷன் ஆஃப் தட் பியூட்டி ஷி இஸ் சோ பியூட்டிஃபுல் மேனகா தாதிருஷ மேனகா தாம்பூல கரண்டம் வஹதி. Next, Ramba. What does Ramba do? She does Chamaram for Indra. So, Madana, Mada, Kadushna, Sauvarga, Kamini, Kataksha, Samsarga, Nivaranaya, Iva. Mani Chamara, Ubai. So, Rambhaya, what is the adjective for Ramba? She starts to use the Chamaram. Mani Chamara, the Chamara has a lot of jewels in it. Mani Chamara, Upavijana, waving that Chamaram. Okay, so upavijane kushala sa kushalataya she starts that with a great expertise. She knows how to do that chamaram. Now what is the cause or what is the result of that? Poet is imagining here. See, the moment people see Indra, there are so many ladies there in Amaravati, and when the ladies see Indra, they have the effects of Manmatha in them, and so their body is heated up because of that. So Madana Mada Kadushna, their body is slightly warm because of the effects of Madana Manmatha. Who are they? Sauvarga Kamini. Swargasya idam Sauvargam. So Swarge Bhavaha Kaminyaha Tesham Kataksha. They look at Indra. Tesham kataksha samsarga. When they look at Indra, the eyes come and fall on Indra. Maybe it will make him also hot, right? So, madana mada kadushna kataksha. Their eyesight is very hot. And in order to remove that heat, it seems as if Ramba is doing the chamaram. So, kadushna samsarga, kataksha samsarga nivaranaya. In order to remove that heat, Ramba starts doing that chamaram. Rambhaya savilasam, very sportingly, that is savilasam, very beautifully, they are all, both of these, that is Menaka on one side, she is carrying the betel nut, and the other side Ramba is standing doing chamaram. Okay, so here you have the phala utpreksha, where she is not actually trying to remove, but he is imagining that she is trying to remove the heat that comes from the Kamini Kataksha Samsargat. So Kamini Kataksha Samsarga Nivaranam Rambayaha Phalam Chamara Vijanasya Phalam. Enama?
Is it okay? Idhila vandu சம்சர்க்க நிவாரணாய இவன் வருது பலோத்ரேக்ஷா.
எஸ்
போனதுல வந்து அபியர்த்தனாய ஆகதம் இவன், அது ஆகதமோட போறது, அதனால ஹேது
அங்கேயும் இருக்கலாம். சோ ஆகதம் இவ அபியர்த்தனாய இன் ஆர்டர் டு இல்லையா, சோ தட் பிகம்ஸ் அ ஹேது. ஹியர் நிவாரணாய இஸ் த பலம் ஹியர் because she does and removes it la idiyum hetu nu solriya nee
illa illa adiyum phalam nu sollama nu ketta
adiyum phalam nu angaradhukka illiye it is just he has come there.